All right, so the goal of this video is to ensure no leads slip through the cracks by showing you exactly what happens when a lead comes in. So let's get started. First, I want to go over some brief principles to response handling, starting with the speed at which you reply. HubSpot and countless other sites have found that the faster you respond, the more likely that lead is to move forward in your sales pipeline. So ideally, we want to respond when they're on LinkedIn within 10 to 15 minutes of them replying to you. Next, we want to keep your replies to 1 to 3 sentences. Big mistake we see is our clients trying to sell over the LinkedIn inbox, but it's too long of a message and it ends up getting skipped. You want to sell over the phone or over email, which leads me to step three. We want to move the conversation off of LinkedIn, meaning asking that lead for their email or phone number to set up a time. Then number four, we want to track every single lead so that number five, we can follow up 3 to 7 times minimum throughout the year. The gold is in the follow-up. Often time is off or it's not a priority for your prospect at the moment. So we definitely want to follow up. I will show you exactly how that looks now. So this is the lead handling sequence. It's 3 steps. First thing we want to do is come to our email inbox where we set up notifications so that LinkedIn will email you every time a reply comes in. So you're going to get this email, you're going to click view message, and it's going to pop up a message inbox right here in LinkedIn, which you can reply to directly. And that's the first way. And then I will show you another way to organize leads as well. As you can see, it popped up here. The next way is to come to your LinkedIn inbox by clicking messaging. And this is the best way to ensure you don't miss any unread messages, is there's these little 3 lines here where you'll click. It's a filter. So you can filter by unread messages so that you can handle everything that hasn't been read. And then, of course, you can come here to archived, which is another way to organize leads where, for example, every time I get a positive reply, I may archive that lead so that at the end of the month, I can see all my positive archive responses. So definitely use this filter. And then once you get a lead and reply to it, we're going to want to come to our lead tracker. So this lead tracker will be shared with you from Cleverly. If it hasn't already, it'll come within today or tomorrow. And what this is every time a prospect replies, we auto-populate a row here with all these columns, company name, location, etc. This is pretty much in real time within 10 minutes of someone replying. It's going to auto-populate a row at the bottom of the doc. And so what you'll want to do is constantly have this open and update it based on the status of that lead. So this is a real client that I duplicated here where he marked the status of that lead. He sent a reply. They weren't interested, scheduled a call, etc., so that he can filter down the line and follow up with leads accordingly. But it's as simple as that. And after you reply and organize that lead, next is follow up. And now the next video that you're going to watch is exactly how to reply to leads. Okay. One more important thing about this lead tracker. I would use this column, the notes column. Don't add any special columns here because it may interfere with our automation. And that is all. Thank you all.